Hello.
We're here.
We're here. Another one.
I know it's a tiger, but lions don't care about the opinion of the sheep. It's the,
it doesn't work.
Doesn't work. Tigers, probably the same thing. Near enough.
But tiger.
Yeah, there you go.
Tigers don't care about the opinion.
It's an addition to the studio, isn't it?
They all say that, don't they?
All the mentors say that. Yeah.
Usually when they've been slagged off for something that they've actually done.
yeah, morally and ethically corrupt, but yeah, don't care about your opinion.
Yeah, lions don't care about sheep.
That's fine.
They will when you hear what they're complaining about. I think there's been a...
Don't say that on YouTube. To be fair, we haven't monitored... You might have noticed this. I don't know, you may or may not. You may have YouTube Premium. There's no ads on any of our videos at the moment. You may have noticed. We could put ads on our videos. We do have the ability to monetize, but when you get 300 views max a video, you don't make that much money, so it seems somewhat pointless. No. It ruins the viewer experience. We may as well not bother.
You should get YouTube Premium though. It's very good.
Yeah, because then if we do monetize it, we get the money and you don't see the ads. So
there you go.
Win-win. We get the 50 cents a video that we're getting at the moment. We should be getting. We're missing out on that.
Over 3 years, that's...
Well, the way that the pound's going at the moment, 50 cents of dollars is a lot of money.
I went to watch 50 cents the other day, actually.
Oh, yeah?
I did, actually.
In his candy shop?
£1.23 with inflation.
yeah.
Dad jokes.
Yeah, he's waiting for that, isn't he?
I did go and watch him.
He must be old now.
He used to be trimmed, didn't he?
He used to be in shape. He's fat now.
Oh, God, very fat.
Yeah. Well, you would, though, wouldn't you? If you're that rich and you had all that, all that wealth, you wouldn't give a shit.
Yeah, he was massive.
It's the jowls, isn't it? Yeah. I saw an interesting Twitter thread the other day from someone, a decent amount of following, and I was talking about mindset and things like that. And he was saying that some of the biggest flexes...
Was it Jim Elton, was it?
No, it wasn't him. No. I said big on Twitter. Someone useful on Twitter.
Yeah. Someone useful.
It was basically the three biggest flexes. And one of them was, there's obviously wealth. It's like, obviously that. And he said, being anonymous, that you're that well off, you do that well that people don't know who you are.
Yeah.
And then he said,
we're doing well at that one.
Yeah. We're doing, that's what we're going for. We're going for that one. That's our goal.
No one knows how
And he said, great physique. They're the three flexes. And I was like, obviously if you had one of them, you wouldn't need the others.
Yeah.
So if you're really rich, obviously
you don't need
a physique.
No.
But it's interesting because I think that a lot, I speak to my coaches about this a lot, is that people need to talk more about how that is actually a good flex, is being in shape.
Yeah,
don't talk about enough.
Especially
it's a bit unsaid, isn't it? You can't really say it, but we've just said it. So
yeah, we have said it.
It's not like us to say things that should be unsaid, but
we've always said that. So I went to see him. It was very good actually. Brought back some small memories. I used to listen to 50 Cent back in the day.
Listen to him now. What are you on about? Back in the day, look at you.
Cruising.
Yeah. Still listen to him now, and you feel.
In what?
I was about to say, double O, but that wasn't.
Doesn't work.
Anyway, you sat here listening to this for too long now. You're like, fucking hell, get on with it. Jesus.
Are they? I think they are. I think they're loving every moment.
Saying that, the 200 views we get is probably me and you watching it back 10 times each. So,
yeah,
it's only 160
still
views.
Laughing. Still laughing at the jokes.
Yeah. But yeah.
What are we talking about?
We're Dan and Mike, and we're here to help you with your online coaching business. We're here to dispel all the shit that you see on social media and just tell you what we've done to get what we've got and throw in some useful tips along the way. And I don't put words in your mouth, but it has been said that there's more actionable, useful, down-to-earth, what was the other one? Information in our videos than people have seen in paid-for mentorships. That's a direct quote from someone. So
Direct quote. If you want any free stuff from us, more free stuff, find us on Instagram, Mike Biceps Banter, Dan Biceps Banter, clues in the name.
Yeah.
Go and find us. If you don't, you probably do already follow us on Instagram.
Because that's probably how you found us.
If you haven't, then hit us up and we can give you some free stuff.
But also pay us if you want. There's a £49 group you can join.
We have a £49 membership.
We actually
group.
Give you advice, this sort of advice, but only applicable to your actual business.
Better, if anything.
So. That's the pitch out of the way. But anyway, today we're going to talk about Instagram because we just touched on Instagram then. We're going to talk about Reels. We're going to talk about the algorithm. We're going to talk about your content and all this sort of stuff. And certain things we're noticing, certain trends we're noticing from coaches and what they're saying and what they're thinking. And we're just here to dispel some of those myths and tell you that you don't need to worry about certain things and that you're probably focusing on the wrong shit.
I think Instagram is done wrong by most coaches, if I'm being completely honest, for many reasons. I think
I will just post on Instagram and get some clients first though before I listen to your advice.
I love that.
I think
I'm just gonna start posting, get a few clients in, and then it's that easy.
Then I'll get some mentoring.
Then I'll do it. Okay,
it's not how it works.
Well,
is it?
It's not how it works.
It is that easy, just post on Instagram.
I wish
Well, my reach is really shit. Oh, I'm not really reaching anyone. Yeah, there's a reason for that.
But yeah, I think fundamentally, coaches just do Instagram wrong. They look at other coaches. They're just putting out content that's blah. And they're tracking the metrics and the data. Well, they're not tracking it, for one.
Well, yeah,
but they're looking at the metrics and the data, thinking that they know what it means, and then making snap judgments on whether it's a success.
I think one of the problems with it is that PTs have a really, online coaches have a really bad view of Instagram, what it is, because they get, oh, my Instagram hates me, it's my reach is crap, the algorithm this, and it's like, it's a free platform, right? To get your information out there, yeah. Which didn't exist. Like, it just didn't exist. Like, can you imagine trying to do PT in, you know, 20, 30 years ago?
Yeah.
It'd been a lot harder. And like, it's just always...
Does Yellow Pages still exist?
Not anymore, surely not.
Does it?
You just Google it, wouldn't you? Yeah, it's a Google version, maybe, I don't know.
I would.
But... They look at it as like, oh, it hates me, no, it's not good enough, or my reach isn't great. And it's like, you're getting that reach, whatever reach you're getting is for free, number one.
Yeah.
All right.
So it is great.
So it is pretty good then, isn't it? And they always, whenever I speak to coaches, there's always a negative view of it. It's always, Instagram isn't doing enough for me. It's not doing enough for me. Yeah, it's not like, it's not good. Like, I just feel like it hates me.
Them.
Yeah, like, yeah. Like, again, it's that.
Oh, why isn't my content being shown to 100,000 people?
It's that victim mindset as well of it. It's like, well, how much are you putting into the platform? Like, how much are you giving the platform on a daily basis? So coaches,
I don't want to spend too much time on it.
I don't want to spend any time on it. I want to post and then run away. Like, the amount of coaches who post three times a week, they then run away from Instagram. Like, I don't want to interact with anyone. I don't want to go on my stories. I just want to post three times, get loads of clients and run away from
it. I'm not doing it at weekends.
Yeah, I don't want to do it at weekends. It's my time.
Yeah.
Okay, yeah. That's what Instagram's saying as well, though. Then at weekends, yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
It's okay, if it's your time, have your time then. We'll leave you alone. And it's a bit of a give and take thing. Like, again, if you said to your clients, like, if they checked in with you once every 4 weeks, but like, oh, you're not making the most of this. Like, you're not going to get the most out of it. It's the same with Instagram.
It's probably one of the most common things is that we're turning up, doing our check-ins, one-to-one check-ins with coaches, you know. Is it one-to-one, though? You know,
Well, yeah, directly one-to-one.
He said it is. So on his mother's life. Nah. On his mother's grave. But yeah, we check in with people, and it seems to be the same common problems come up with, this didn't perform well, that didn't perform well, I'm getting nothing back from Instagram, this, that, and the other. And it's just because you're fundamentally looking at it incorrectly. How do you determine what a success is? For one, people are complaining about their reel only got a certain amount of views or not or whatever. But that doesn't actually matter. So I had a couple of clients not long ago who went through a spate of getting like 15 to 25,000 views on the reels. And I said to them, did it change your business? Did any extra come in? No. Okay. So now learn from that and realize that even if it goes to 15, 20, 25K, then it's not necessarily going to change your business. So then you can't look at that as a success then. But equally, you could have a video that got 500 views, but actually one person out of that 500 really, really resonated with it and bought from you, signed up for coaching. So you need to reframe what you're doing and what success is, because it's then clouding your judgment moving forwards. Because you'll go, oh, this reel got that, or this reel got that. Or I saw somebody the other day go, I've seen a guy on Instagram who's getting like 100,000 views because he's doing recipe ideas. So I think I'm going to do that. What the fuck?
Yeah.
What the fuck? Oh, you think you're going to do that? Well, there's people who are getting their fucking boobs and their bum out on Instagram, but that's not going to help your fucking business, is it? Like, it's just, wow. You know, that's not for us to say.
Yeah.
You know,
I mean,
try it. Didn't work for you when you tried it.
No.
No. But Weasel, Arseface Weasel. probably.
That's what the real said. Got banned from Instagram for that.
But it's just madness. It's like, you're looking, it's weird that online coaches are looking to grow a business, but yet for some reason, it's almost like you're looking at, you're trying to be an Instagram celebrity and I need to get viral. And if you think about it, if you've got 2,000 followers, let's say, and you've got 10 clients, you haven't exhausted those 2,000 followers. Like, that's not it. You haven't exhausted them. Because if you work off that logic then, well, you will need 4,000 followers to get 20 clients and 6,000 to get 30 clients. It doesn't happen like that. Like, your focus shouldn't be solely on views on things and analyzing the this reel got that and I can't see a correlation between this. Fucking stop it. Just put out content that you like to put out, that you enjoy, that is niche related, and do it consistently over time. And it doesn't fucking matter. We don't even look at our real views. The only time I look at our real views is if I'm on my own Instagram with during one of the live video updates that we do every week. You know, what, you do them live videos? What, with every coach? Yeah.
Every week.
Not every week, though. Well, every week. The only time I go on it is when I click on my Instagram and show them around my Instagram, which I do for all one-to-one.
Every single coach. Yeah, it's mine. Yeah.
So, you know, I'll show them my messages and how I do outreach and, you know, all the three secret tips that you guys probably aren't doing. So, you know, that's obviously a pitch. But I'll go on and say, look, this reel got 4,000, this reel got 2,000, that one got 8,000. Doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. You're focusing on the wrong metric. The metric is the amount of posts. It's the amount of posts and the amount of contact that you have with your followers.
The other one you get as well with coaches is got this reel got loads of views, but wrong type of views.
Yeah, right. It's the wrong type.
Oh, right, okay. Yeah, it's like, oh, they're all from an area of the world where I wouldn't get any clients from.
Well,
do you know?
Where, from where?
To wherever.
Wow.
And it's this whole thing of you can't win with coaches, I feel like you can't win. Like, you moan about not getting any views, and then you moan about getting loads of views because the wrong type of views. And then you moan because it's not putting in front of the right people and all this sort of stuff. And like Mike said, the reality is if you keep turning up all the time, posting niche content that's relevant to your niche, people will be taking it in, paying attention, and they will be noticing you. And I think that there's just been this huge boom of like moving towards reels and just focusing purely on, again, numbers again, and views and likes and all that sort of stuff. And I've seen a lot of people do it. And I, again, like you said, you go, well, has the business improved because of it? No.
No.
It hasn't. And you get fundamentally.
This, I'm not going to do carousels because it only gets like 7 or 8 likes. So,
yeah,
it doesn't matter. It really doesn't matter. We've had people sign up and join our one-to-one coaching where you get videos every week.
Too many pictures.
Yeah. Too many now. It is too many. No, we've had people just have his phone.
Just turn it on, do not disturb.
Just have his phone in.
Just realize it was on.
Wow, that's professionalism. And that is what I want.
Yeah.
No, we've had people like come into coaching who have not liked our stuff. Like, I'm sure it was you. Was it you or was it one of my clients who they had two people sign up off the back of a transformation, but neither of them had liked it? Was it you?
No.
No, it must be one. Must be one of the coaches that I coach. You know, bespokely every single week. Keeps going. It must have been one of those guys. And I said to him, look, like, I thought it was you, but it was someone else. So whoever it was, I said, look.
Well, you don't give me my one-to-one bespoke feedback every week. So.
No, I don't. Not worth it. He doesn't implement it. I tell him, you know, carry that bag. And, you know, he doesn't do it. But I was like, there you go. I was like, two people have signed up off the back of a transformation you put up, but neither of them liked it. What does that say? Is that people aren't necessarily liking the stuff. It doesn't mean it's not landing with them, that they're not watching it, that they're not, you know, being triggered by it, or they're finding value in it, or they're finding entertainment in it, or it's now the right time for them. You just got to stay in the game, like with Instagram and your posting. That's what you've got to do. You've got to be there and present, ready for when they want to join up, not when you want them to join up.
Yeah. That's one of the biggest questions I ask coaches that I work with as well, by the way, one-to-one.
Do you do it?
Live.
Every week?
Every week, okay, yeah. Every week. Is I ask them, like, how do they use Instagram? So people always, you know, they say, oh, I put out a call to action. I put the, you know, comment below with the word this and no one did it. And I'm like, okay, cool. How many times have you ever done that on someone's post? None. Because I haven't.
No.
And I follow a fair few people who have free guides, free stuff, all this sort of thing, right? And people that I've actually worked with, like mentoring, coaching. I don't like, I've got a coach for my own fitness stuff. I don't like all of his posts. I don't like many of his posts.
Game sack.
Bastard.
Knew he would.
I don't like many of his posts or save them or anything like that, right? And I didn't before as well either. And I think there's this whole thing around understanding how you use Instagram and understanding how people who follow you will use it. Just because someone doesn't like your post doesn't mean they didn't watch it. Doesn't mean that they don't, you know, enjoy your content. And people are just so quick to judge their whole Instagram content strategy on whether someone liked a post of theirs. And I follow loads of people, I don't like their stuff. I've reposted funny videos that I've not even liked. I just reposted it because it's a funny video. And then not even followed the account because it was just like, why would I follow the account? It was just one video that I liked. Mm-hmm. Again, it's like with the reels. You might get one video that goes well, but that might just be the only video that resonated with people, and that's fine. There's nothing wrong with that.
Think about it like this. If you are sat here and you've had a video that had over 10,000 views, did it even equate to any extra followers? No, it didn't. Like, it doesn't. Like, I think our reels are somewhere, I don't know, between what, 2,000 and 5,000?
Around that.
But we've had ones that go to 10, 12. Mm-hmm. We've not had any additional followers. Like, it doesn't matter. And it's just annoying. Now, on the flip side of that is that with your content, a lot of coaches moan that it doesn't land or they're not getting stuff through. And I do want to say that it's got to look half decent. Like, yeah, you've still got to put some effort into it. And if you're sat here as a coach and you look at your Instagram and then you go and look at 10 or 20 other coaches' pages and you say, if yours isn't in the top 3, 4 of how good it looks, how well branded it is, how professional the setup looks, ask yourself, why isn't it? Like, why isn't it? Because some people will go, oh, this reel didn't go very well. Well, yeah, because it's on a grainy camera. You're sat in your car. There's no fucking title on it. There's no backing. Yep. The audio's dreadful. Like, you've turned up the fucking backing music to 50 on it, so you can barely 50. Bentley.
On your brain, isn't it? It's on your brain, that.
50. Well, you said 50 cents straight away.
50 cents, isn't it?
But that's just an example of some of the rapping that I can do.
But you're right, though, because, like, we see it all the time. Like, and you just kind of feel a bit like, take it seriously. Like, again, show to people that follow you, that you want to sign up as clients, that you do this properly as a job, and you're not just a half-assed coach that films stuff in their car because you don't want to do it in the house for whatever reason. And it baffles me that, again, these are really simple things. You don't even have to be a great coach to do that bit right. You don't, like, that's forgetting your coaching and your niche. That's just getting that bit right. But it's this whole concept, oh, the algorithm hates me. No, the algorithm will send good content to people. And half of that is how it looks. Mm-hmm. There's a reason that on your explore page, things look better. Mm-hmm. You don't get many selfie videos in a car on your explore page. You just don't. No. And I think that you need to start, again, spending time on Instagram and researching stuff. Like, spend time on it, looking at your explore page. Well, what sort of things are coming up when I'm looking at fitness stuff? What sort of things are people interested in? Or are they trying to send my way? And they did an Instagram Reels recommendations guidelines the other day. We posted it in our members group. Give you a bit of insight into that.
49.
I'm not going to tell you the link to that. You can go and join the group for it. But basically, they gave guidelines for what they want Reels to look like. If you want your Reels to be recommended on someone else's page, they have to fit a certain criteria on the page.
Some juicy stuff now.
And it's... I'm not going to tell you what it is.
Oh.
So, no.
I don't even know.
One of them had to be that it was under 60 seconds, number one. Has to be under 60 for it to be recommended. Has to be under 60 seconds. So okay. Reels can go longer than that now.
I'm always under 60 seconds. I'll be fine.
You can do it twice.
Yeah.
And then the other parts of it were there can't be any watermarks or logos on it. There can't be any sort of branding and things like that on it.
Again,
because they don't want the TikTok stuff on it. But I would even say any sort of branding on it because, again, they want it to be sort of like real curated content. And it had to be original. It couldn't be a repost from someone else. It had to be original content that you'd created, that you'd uploaded, and all that sort of stuff. And the other part of it is that it needs to look good. And when you read the recommendations, part of it boils down to it needs to look good. That's basically what they said mm-hmm. in as many words. And like I said, remember how you use it and what videos and photos you click on. Like people saying, oh, photos are dead on Instagram. They're not. They're just not. Same carousels. They're not dead.
Yeah.
They're just shit ones are dead. Yeah, of course they are. But shit content in general is dead. Yeah. And like the real, so there's another article about Reels and about how actually they haven't gone as well as Instagram thought they would and all this sort of mm-hmm. stuff. And how actually a lot of people aren't engaging with them. And actually that the experiment to try and be like TikTok hasn't actually worked. And some people are posting Reels and just getting no engagement whatsoever on them. Which makes sense because some of you watching may have got the same thing. It's not necessarily that your Reels are necessarily bad or they're not hitting or whatever. It's just that, is it in line with your content strategy in general? Because you should still be posting photos and carousels and other content because it shouldn't matter the format you put your content out there. If it's in the right voice and the right tone and the right niche, it will land if that's what we're going to call it. But the algorithm doesn't hate you. The algorithm hates shit content. Let's just call it what it is. The algorithm will push good content. That's what it's designed to do. If your stuff isn't being seen by people who follow you and that sort of stuff, it basically means that Instagram have looked at your content and go, well, the people we have shown it to who follow you don't like it. So I'm not going to show it to more of them. That's your sign to maybe make better content. Just going to throw it out there. like the amount of times that I see someone's post and the first 5 seconds is basically like an introduction to their life before they get to the meat and bones of the content. Well, you've got 3 seconds to draw someone in. So you've just lost that chance straight away. Mm-hmm. Like you see it. So for example, it'll be like this, right? One of the biggest things that I found with my niche and my clients that I think is a really big problem
boring,
with people that are trying to really kind of
not
lose
interested.
Weight, right? Gone. And then they go, you're snacking too much. Start with that. Just start with that. It's not a great hook, right? But it's better than the. I think one of the biggest problems that I see with people who suffer with, oh my God, like fucking.
Yeah.
Nah, you wouldn't watch that. You wouldn't watch it. And like the amount of times that I say to people like, watch it back. Yeah, you're right. And I have to sit there on the one-to-one check-ins that I do with
every
coaches
week.
Filmed every week. Is I bring up their Instagram video and I go, right. And I put a timer on and I go like 1, 2, 3. And I'm like, you've lost them. And I go, you should have started the video there. 10 seconds in there. That's where you should have started it. Cause it comes in with a bang.
Yeah.
And I did a kick breakdown when I do that.
Yeah.
And I did a breakdown the other day of how I edit videos and people were quite surprised. Maybe I'll do a separate YouTube on this. You won't be able to contribute anything to it. But
no, I'll just be sat.
But basically, it's like people have this thing where, again, they film on their phone and they press start and stop on the... Have you seen it? You can see people doing it. Press start and stop on the button to do a video.
What, and they keep that in?
And no, kind of keep it in, but they basically do the reel and they do it in little chunks and then they post it as a whole video. But you can see them like recording in little chunks.
They're reaching forward and doing that.
No. You can see them literally doing it, right? But not only that, is that I film my 1 minute reels. I probably film about 4.5 minutes of footage. Bit precise, 4.5. I know I said four to five, whatever it is.
Yeah.
And I cut out so much guff from
most
that.
Most of it is a good coach, you know.
Just talking normally, you like know, enjoying
and
himself.
They cut out four and a half minutes worth.
And I often take like little chunks out of it, but then I move some of the chunks from the middle or the end to the start. People are baffled by it when I show them. They're like, what? Well, I'm like, well, yeah, because I don't like know how I'm going to start the video. I just start talking. Mm-hmm. Stuff comes out. We then move things around in it. Mm-hmm. But like if we did a YouTube video like this, we do a bit of the guff at the start. It doesn't really matter because you sat down to watch it for 25 minutes because you're invested. You know, you sat down, you want to watch it.
Yeah.
If this was Instagram, we'd start with something more punchy, which is what we do with our reels, which you post on there. It's not like an extended minute of just us talking. We take out the chunks that still make sense and get the message across.
Yeah.
And you might move bits to the start to make it punchier and make people draw people in. Coaches are baffled. Some of them are baffled when I say, yeah, that's how I do it. They're like, what? Yeah. You don't just like go from start to the end. I'm like, no.
No,
because you have to make it engaging and interesting and worth someone's time watching. So when you say the algorithm hates you, it doesn't.
Well,
it hates shit content.
It's like what Chris said. So in our group, we've got some expert lectures.
For £49 a month? There's experts in there.
Yeah, 49 okay, quid. Yeah, mad. Madness. Fucking hell, this is bad, isn't it? You know.
We're just rolling with it now, though.
In it, yeah.
So just keep going with it now.
I don't think we do enough CTAs.
No.
Yeah, do more CTAs, by the way.
That's also a thing, yeah.
And Chris said with his copy, he suggests writing as he would, and then reading, and the first line that makes you go, that's a good line, delete everything before it. It's the same with video.
Yeah.
It's exactly the same with video, because you will know if it's fucking fluff.
Almost do need to have the start to warm yourself up to the actual content, like so that in your head you say it in the right order and stuff like that.
Yeah.
It's just that coaches post that bit. You can just delete it. You can, and that's the other one that annoys me, is that like the same with the emails, like Chris was talking there, is you just start writing and then you delete the start bit.
Yeah.
Is that they think they have to write the perfect email. Oh, it didn't sound very good. Then they delete the whole thing.
Yeah.
The same with videos. They make a mistake a minute in. Oh, I've got to delete the whole thing. Start again now.
No.
Just keep the camera rolling.
Yeah.
Just say it again. And you can just edit that bit out.
Yeah.
It baffles me. Blows my mind if people don't do that.
Yeah, it's madness. Think about, like, even with stuff that you watch on TV, is that we've just watched Clarkson's Farm, right?
Very good. A bit late to the party, but...
Not together, yeah.
No.
A bit late, but yeah, Dan suggested it. And I went in and watched it again. But, like... That shows you what's ahead for the show. The little trailer, the little hook that gets you in, that makes you want to watch the show, or even at the end of one, it shows you what's going to happen next. It doesn't start with, hi, I'm Jeremy Clarkson. And like that's what happens when the show starts, once you're hooked. But it'll have snippets and clips of the things that do happen that make you then want to watch the rest of it. Think of that in terms of your content. Have the snippets and the things that make you want to watch the rest of the reel. Because it's engaging and it's interesting. And that's what you need to do.
And likewise, right? So to use that as a good analogy, is that...
It is a good analogy.
It is a good analogy. You know? You also and can't...
I have many more good analogies on...
in the 49-pound group. So
in the 49-pound group.
Is that you also couldn't watch something like that if it was just trailers. So people talk about reels all the time. Oh, I need to get my reels going on and post loads of reels. If you just post reels, you don't actually post enough content that's going to actually make someone realize you know what you're talking about and that there's stuff in there that's useful. So you then have to have carousels and transformation posts and social proof to show people how it all comes together. So a carousel would have a lot more information in it that maybe people would save or is actionable or is a bit more opinionated and valuable, whereas a reel might just try and draw someone in a bit quicker and it's a little bit maybe 15, 20 seconds and that could just be it. Is you need to understand how all this stuff relates to your whole strategy. I don't personally believe that accounts that just post reels all the time are as successful as those that have a good mixture of stuff. So for example, the reels are great for drawing people in. Okay, so where are you then sending them to? Hopefully you've got a free guide or a free thing that you give people so you can get them signed up to your email list. Your email list can then have longer form content. You can have carousels that are slightly longer form. You can have YouTube videos that are slightly longer form that you can send to an email list. So yes, the reels are great, and yes, doing that sort of thing on video is great, but it's to draw people in and it's to get them excited and hooked. Once they're in, you then need to give them more stuff that is useful, that does show you know what you're talking about. You can't just post reels. And this is the thing I think a lot of coaches went wrong with when reels started getting bigger, is they just posted them. They grew quite quick, but then people followed them and realized, well, there's nothing here of any value. You just keep posting reels of fucking food you find in Asda. Great. Ooh. Find it in any shop, but whatever. Tesco.
Whatever.
A lot of that, though. You know, a lot of like...
There are other supermarkets available.
It's really weird. Yeah. And there needs to be some substance behind it. Once you've got people in and they go, okay, this guy looks all right, this girl, whichever.
You know.
Can you say that these days?
Well, could
person,
be.
Person? Whatever person.
Is it a person, though?
You allowed these to say days? That?
I don't know.
They're in, and you then go, well, I now actually know my stuff. It's not just fancy videos that look great and the lighting's all perfect and, you know, you've got microphones and stuff.
You know,
it doesn't have to be like that all the time. But you then draw them in and go, well, look, this is actually then how good I am at my job. And I can actually help you with stuff that's valuable, not just pretty reels that hook you in.
Yeah, that's, again, just coaches just use it wrong. Like, there's no clue. It's just needed.
But coaches just want the thing that is popular at the time.
Yeah.
They want the thing that's getting the most reach, the most likes, the most saves. Like, well, trust me, you don't, because your account isn't set up to draw people in because it looks like shit. So even if they did come in, you've got no lead magnet, you've got nowhere to send them, you've got no email list, you're not sending emails, your emails are shit, you're not doing any of that stuff. So make sure you get all those stuff fundamentals set up first so that when people do come to your page, that they're actually something worth sticking around for. Like, I don't know if you've noticed this, but I actually noticed on my page that I don't see an increase in followers when I necessarily post. I've had days where I don't really post much on Instagram and I'll get like 8-9 followers because people will land on your page and maybe someone else recommended it or whatever. And they just know from looking at it, they like your stuff. Mm. There's not this whole thing of like, if I post a reel, I get 100 new followers. Mm. It doesn't work like that.
No.
Mine are really consistent across the board. Yeah, like whether I post or don't post, or is it, if it's a carousel, if it's a video or whatever, it doesn't seem to make much difference.
Yeah.
And I think that's because our content is a bit broader across the, you know, there's YouTube, there's emails going out. There's always something that's going out somewhere. And you need to think like that rather than just going, oh, my reels are shit or my reels are dying. Well, what else are you doing?
Mm.
What else are you doing?
Exactly.
How else you turn up for people?
But yeah, no, that's a good point. Like we don't grow to any real extent. Like I've, you know, just got under 10,000 followers. Annoying. I'm 100 off.
Doesn't mean anything now, though.
But it's been like that for like ages, and it doesn't necessarily mean anything. Like, I'll look at my insights, you know, I'll get them up on my Instagram as I'm showing, you know, one of my clients. and they watch my videos that I do every week. just keep doing it.
Keep going, Jack.
You know, I'll get my insights up and I'll look back over the last 7 days, and it'll be like, you've had, I don't know, 62 follows, but like 47 unfollows or something. So it's like creeping up. On a week-to-week basis, but it's not by any, you know, stretch of the imagination going viral or anything like that.
It's not viral.
You know, it's not like growing to any huge amounts, but I would probably hazard a guess that near enough every single month since me and Dan started has probably been a personal best month in terms of revenue. So it doesn't necessarily matter, and there's going to be people with larger followings and so on and so forth that don't know how to use, you say don't know how to use Instagram properly, because you would assume that they do because they had more followers, but it's not about that. Like, who cares if you have more followers? It's about how engaged your following is. That's the thing. How niche is it? How likely are they to buy from you? Because this isn't a popularity contest. It's not like, love me.
God.
Yeah, well, it's not though, is it? It's like, you're not doing this to have more followers. Surely you're doing this to have a better business. So don't correlate the two, that more followers means better business. Of course, if you've got a million followers, yes, it's going to be easy to have a better business because you would just have a lower cost product. But that's not going to happen for any of us. So you've got to make do with what you've got. And that's the thing that you need to get into your head is stop trying to be like Instagram famous and grow. Nurture the things that you do have. A couple of little bonus tips for stories. I reckon we just title this one like everything you need to know about Instagram.
Yeah, if you've got an hour, sit down and watch this.
Everything you need to know about Instagram. So like if you're on your stories, like as it stands watching this video, don't repost anybody else's reels. Don't repost your own reels. Like it's already on your page.
Well, this is just stuff we've noticed. For our accounts
and others, so everybody else that I'm telling at my weekly check-ins that I do every week I do them.
They one to one. Yeah. Okay.
With coaches just like you, could even be you. And if it is you, just tell everybody how good it is below
in the comments. Just say amazing.
In the comments. Yeah. You know, no, it is working. It is working.
So, again, like we've. So, for example, with that, it goes against conventional wisdom because I've seen people recommend you repost your reels and post to stories and you do all this sort of thing and reshare stuff, right? But just from trial and error, we've noticed certain things. We've noticed that, yeah, so if you reshare other people's stories that they've tagged you in on your page, kills your reach,
yep.
No matter what you say. And so then we started looking at it and going, cool, why is this? Why is this happening? Again, if you put a new post you put up on your stories, again, kills the reach of your stories across the board. Because what we noticed was we have a certain amount of stories that we average about on a normal day. And we started noticing trends. And we don't just mean like doing it once or twice. I mean consistently over time. And we were like, okay, cool. So what happens if we delete that reel off our story that we reposted? You start to see it reach go back up again. What happens if you delete that? You see it reach go back up again. And you start noticing these trends happening. And it does make sense when you really think about it and break it down that Instagram wants the stories to be its own little thing, right, that people use. And the same thing applies for stories as it does with your posts. Is it down to engagement and it's down to original content? It comes down to those two things. So you may have noticed from watching us, we don't do as many of the talking head videos anymore as we used to. We used to talk to the camera on a selfie mode like that a lot of the time. And since stories has moved to a lot more algorithm-based stuff where they're showing more stories to people who are actually engaged, they get less engagement because people don't unmute on those stories as much anymore. They skip through them if they see a lot of them in a row because it's a bit boring. It's not what they turned up for because I don't know if you've noticed this, but even watching TV in your own home, if you're watching it, you won't put the sound on your Instagram. You'll just skip through it. And where we are here, you can't put the captions on. But I don't think it would make a difference, personally. I don't think the captions would the people just aren't interested in that on stories anymore. Yeah. So what we've noticed is that if you put longer text stories up, people hold their thumb on it to read it, which again is telling Instagram there's engagement if people want to watch it, or they skip back. So again, if you're on stories, I've noticed that if you have a high proportion of your stories that people have pressed the back button, it's telling Instagram, well, I wanted to read that. It was quite good. I want to check it out again. So when you start looking at the numbers of reach you get, you start noticing these things. What we've noticed is that our reach is now consistently higher than it has been before because we're consistently posting text, photos, behind the scenes stuff, but original stuff. We're not resharing stories. We're not resharing posts to our thing. And consistently, we're at a really high, for us, high number.
And deleting, wake up every morning and delete yesterday's stories as well seems to work. Yeah. So again, goes against what other people are saying. Other people are saying, don't never delete it. But genuinely, like watching this, wake up tomorrow morning, delete all of yesterday's and restart again.
And wait 20 minutes.
Leave it 20 minutes, half an hour. Restart again. Maybe do something that's engaging in the morning, like a quiz or a poll or something like that. I bet you it doubles. Just as we were coming into here, one of my clients who I work with on a weekly basis.
One to one.
He said his has doubled since he started implementing this. Yeah. Like, has doubled. And I would say that ours is. I would say that mine is halved when I don't do this, and it's doubled when I do this. So delete everybody yesterday's stories, and that's it. Like, be gone. Like, whoever was going to watch it has watched it by now. Stop being precious about it. It's only got a 24-hour lifespan anyway. Just get rid of it. And then just start again. And 6 to 10 stories each day, that's it. That's all you need. And it should be engaging. Drive engagement with polls, quizzes, text boxes, things like that. It's fine to tag other people in it. Like often when I tag Dan in one of mine, it goes a little bit further. I think there's something there.
It's probably because it's me.
Definitely not. show behind the scenes. And again, as coaches, you should be showing behind the scenes of what you're doing. And I'm not talking about filming what you do and go, so this is one-to-one coaching and you get a this and a that. No, not like that. Like show screenshots of people doing well, people's weight loss, people side by sides. Be arrogant a little bit about it. Be a bit like, this is how online coaching should be done. You know, one-to-one check-ins every week. Every week. Yeah. By video as well. like be arrogant about it and show behind the scenes, show what you do. And then other things, like we are big fans of showing the parts of you that are outside of fitness. So Dan does his scrambled eggs that he will not stop doing. You know, where he posts his scrambled eggs every morning and he gets engagement from that and so on and so forth. Like it's about building that know, like, and trust that people see the little bits inside your life. And again, if you look at the people that you most like on Instagram, you probably do see bits of their life or would like to. So that tells you something.
So yeah.
That's everything you need to know about.
That's a long one today.
As it stands, by the time they finish watching this, it's probably something new.
It's probably changed. Yeah. But you will have to change with the times. Again, the algorithm stuff, like, again, you do have to change with the times. You have to think about it. But as we will always say, is if you have good quality, niche-specific content, it will land. It doesn't matter what format you use or how you do it. It's about your message at the end of the day that's consistent, that's unique to you. It'll work. If you try follow trends and you try follow things like that, it will fuck up for you at some point, because like you shouldn't be worried about the algorithm changing. No. We're not. We're never worried about anything changing, whether it's reels, whether it's photos, whether it's carousels, whether it's whatever. It doesn't matter, because your message should remain the same throughout and you should find a way of putting that across in a fun way. So just remember that.
There you go.
So yeah, we'll leave it there.
That's it. If we've not mentioned it, we do one-to-one coaching every week, videos, and we also have a £49 members group. So
check that out first, because that's where all the best bits are.
Go to the members group. That's the best. It's the cheapest. It's more of this, but better. You know, you get to ask us direct questions, and if that means anything,
direct access to us. So you know. Anyway, have a good one. Share this with everyone, please. Anyone and everyone.
Nobody. Need to hear it. Yeah, no one. That's it. Isn't it?